Festival. We've got an all-star Canadian lineup with artists all the way from Vancouver, BC to Cambridge Bay, Nunavut to St. John's, Newfoundland, including the new Pornographers, Tokyo Police Club, Maestro Fresh West, Whitehorse, Alvvays, and Tanya Tagaq. First up, our headliners. Hey Rosetta is a powerhouse seven-piece band from St. John's, Newfoundland, known for their cinematic sound. They're not your typical rock band. They combine thoughtful lyrics with lush pop symphonies and have a magnetic way of drawing in their audience to make you feel.
So your lyrics are incredibly smart, your music is sophisticated, but it's also really fun, and I feel confused about whether I should think or dance while I'm listening to you guys. Which one is it?
I don't know, I hope it makes you dance when you feel like dancing, and maybe, and when you're alone, you can let it wash over you in a different way, you know? That's the music I like the most, so I hope that's what we make.
Come on, let your red heart show. All right, come on. Repeat after me, here we go. Come on, let your red heart show.
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 Come on, let your red heart.
Hey Rosetta, and later in the show, they'll play a moving tribute to Gord Downie. But right now, it's all about the new Pornographers. They started out in Vancouver almost 20 years ago as the brainchild of A.C. Newman. Individually, these are some of the most talented musicians from the West Coast, and together, they're a bona fide supergroup. Check them out.
Music that puts people in a really good mood. Do you have to actually be in a good mood to play music that puts people in a good mood?
I think just starting to play helps. Like, you get on stage and you go like, oh, right, I remember this.
Yes.
I remember why we do this.
Yeah.
This is the cool job.
I know these songs.
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought I didn't know them a couple days ago, but now I totally know them.
Yeah, sometimes you're playing a song and going, oh, this is us? I like this one.
What's the biggest difference between prepping for a regular concert and prepping for a festival experience?
It's really hard to get a drink at a festival. So even if you're headlining a festival, God help you if you wanted like a gin and tonic and it's 5 p.m. Because I like gin and tonics because the glasses.
The glasses.
I'm just pretending that I drink all day just because it seems sort of rock and roll. I don't want to give in that my life is basically just a stay-at-home dad most of the time.
Answering questions about new pornographers for a long time, like almost two decades. What question are you most sick of at this point in your career?
What is it in the water that makes so many good Canadian bands? That one really bugs me. It's like,
why?
What is it in the, well, it's nothing. It's just a bunch of people who got together and tried to be good. And it happens all over the world.
Everybody.
You just heard from Vancouver's The New Pornographers, and now we're heading east to Ontario to check in with a band who's pretty much living every teenage musician's dream.
Our next guests are an acclaimed Canadian rock and roll band. Please welcome Tokyo Police Club. I'm on your team.
Tokyo Police Club started off as a high school band in small town Newmarket, and now they tour the world with their critically acclaimed records.
All the boys who called their mothers on that day.
In the last decade, they've pretty much played every festival there is. They've rocked The Late Show with David Letterman three times, but no matter where they go or what stage they play, they're still just a bunch of dudes who want to make you dance.
So you guys have been together for quite some time, right?
You know, we started in grade four, coloring things in with crayons, and now we're here coloring things in with crayons.
It's a full circle moment.
Full circle moment.
Faces, because that's what kids are doing right now in the kids' tent.
Can't talk coloring.
Oh, sorry.
And I wonder what you're doing tonight. I've burned our house down by the end of the night. I didn't need the money, but the money was nice. I need a countdown.
actually, though, feel as good as I think it would to have started a band with your buddies back in, you know, fourth grade or whatever, and now be living the life that you live?
I think it feels really normal. Like, the continuity of our lives is alarmingly straight. I think we were just friends, and then we were a band and friends, and we're still that.
I think most people have this, like, explosive college experience where they like, make new friends and they leave their hometown behind or something, and then you go into the real world, and that's a whole other thing. But we've just kind of had, like the high school bubble has kept going for us for a long time. So what I'm trying to say is that I lack organizational and time management skills that I would have gotten in college.
Well, you got other skills, it's fine.
Coloring skills.
Clearly.
They don't teach you this in college.
I like that Graham is spending all of his time on making his aura explosive there, while Dave has been a bit more democratic about the process.
I didn't come here to make friends.
Time's up. Okay, clock's on. 10.
9.
8.
7.
6.
5.
4. 3. Things are getting crazy. 2. 1. Pencils down.
I crushed it.
Oh.
And I wonder what you do.
I can't explain my art, man. Okay, I just pick up a crayon and let the feelings do the talking.
Cool. I feel like you're...
But I'm the most important part of the band is basically the thesis of this. It's our time.
This is a wax on canvas piece. And here with this impressionistic star, much of like the Surratt variety. And up here we have a more Rembrandt effect happening with the outside of the lions.
Don't go anywhere. Coming up at the CBC Music Festival, the godfather of Canadian hip-hop, Maestro Fresh West.
Everybody, throw your hands in the air.
We're gonna do it up.
And later, Hey Rosetta return with a heartfelt tribute to the Tragically Hip.
That's when the hornet stung me. Then I had a serious dream.
A tribute just to say that we're thinking about him and we love him, you know.
We're all for gore, but this one's for good.
Welcome back to the CBC Music Festival. We are so proud to present an all-Canadian lineup for you. And coming up, you're going to hear from Inuit throat singer Tanya Tagaq, headliners Hey Rosetta, Juno Award-winning duo Whitehorse. But first, this is a throwdown, a showdown.
Hell no, I can't slow down.
Oh!
First offense on
Maestro Fresh West, hip-hop is in the building. We're going to do it up.
If you're listening to hip-hop in Canada, it's probably because of Maestro Fresh West. Back in 1989, he made history as the first Canadian rapper to have a top 40 hit with this game-changing single. Now, almost three decades later, the godfather of Canadian hip-hop is still keeping things fresh.
What's the secret to keeping things fresh after, you know, such a long career?
I think a lot of times, too, is listen to, like, young cats, but know your foundation, know yourself, but be humble enough to listen to what other cats are doing, too, but know that you gotta be yourself at the same time.
Everybody, do me a favor, put your hands up in the air like this. If you love the sunshine, put your hands up like this, everybody. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Now move it side to side, come on. We move it side to side, come on.
Back to your past. Why did you start rapping in the first place, Wes?
I just wanted girls to like me, man. You know what I'm saying?
We move side to side.
The breakdance was getting all the girls, man. So I tried a couple head spins. It didn't work.
Yeah.
But I started rhyming. Girls started feeling me. I started feeling good. You know what I mean? And then I was like, okay, let me just get to write rhymes.
It was the right choice.
It was the right choice, man. And then I got really good at it, and people said, you know, A lot of times people say I was dreaming, it wasn't gonna happen because I'm from Canada, whatever like that. So I'm the type of person, if I believe I can make something happen, I try to make it, yeah, make it happen.
I was the one I used to say, I seen a lot of valleys, I seen a lot of peaks, I seen the bitter with the sweet victory and defeat. Sometimes I felt what a voice kept saying, stick to your vision, leave the composition.
What are you feeling while you're performing?
Nervous.
Seen a lot of pain with the fame, seen a lot of highs and lows, but yes, yes, yes.
It's so humbling to me that you still get nervous knowing what an amazing long career you've
had. But that's just because I respect what I'm doing. You know what I'm saying? I respect fans. People actually bought my records years ago, so I must have done something right.
I did.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So you got to give them a good show.
Shining with clouds are over me, so I recollect. Remember Kid Capri. I'll be your last play my joint when I heard Protect Your Neck back in 92. But let's go back to 88. Flemington, Don Mills and Eglinton. Making beats with S and Jell and Devon. Remember when you labels wasn't feeling me? Next year, change the scenery. Gave birth to your energy. To an iced tea, to the enemy. Watch you gave me love, you suckers had to envy me. Couldn't stand to see your brother shine. Play your haters always working overtime. I seen a lot of valleys, I seen a lot of peaks. I seen the bitter with the sweet victory and defeat. Sometimes I felt what a voice kept saying. Stick to your vision, do the composition. Seen a lot of shame in the game. Seen a lot of pain with the fame.
Maestro, you're big on motivational speaking. You're coaching your son's baseball team. You're a coach. You're a motivator. I have a lot to do today. I got to introduce some bands on stage. Can you give me a pep talk?
You do an awesome job. I saw how you handled yourself.
Oh, thanks. I don't want compliments. I want a pep talk. I want a Coach Fresh pep talk.
Stay hydrated. Very important. Stay hydrated. Toronto, make some noise!
You just heard from Maestro Fresh West, the godfather of Canadian hip hop, and now we're checking in with the cool kids on the Canadian music playground, Alvvays. With only one record under their belt, they've already landed on the Polaris Prize shortlist and rocked festivals like Coachella, Glastonbury, and now CBC Music. Here's Alvvays performing their hot single, Archie, Marry Me.
You've expressed explicitly your contempt for matrimony. We stood in arms to pay and will not risk the alimony. We spent our days up to the moon pointing inside a bubble.
Trouble. next at the CBC Music Festival, an arresting and uniquely Canadian performance from Inuit throat singer Tanya Tagaq. And later...
Missing a horn is something.
Hey Rosetta, pay tribute to Gord Downie and the Tragically Hip.
I don't really have musical heroes or anything, but like he's pretty close. Tonight we smoke them
up. Well, they're all for Gord, but this one's for Gord.
To the all-Canadian extravaganza we call the CBC Music Festival. Coming up, you're gonna hear from your headlining act, Newfoundland's Hey Rosetta. But first, the steamiest couple in Canadian music. Luke Doucette and Melissa McClelland are the Juno Award-winning husband-wife duo behind Whitehorse.
I don't have much, but I got the good stuff.
They're fearless on stage. These two ooze chemistry, and they breathe new life into the classic sounds of the American South. Whitehorse will smash any expectation you might have of a Canadian folk duo.
Of a sad, sad song.
So you guys are two people, and then on stage somehow you sound like 20 people. Please explain yourselves.
When we started this band, we thought of ourselves as a folk duo, and then slowly we sort of broke all the cardinal rules of folk music and wanted to make more sound and more noise. And initially we didn't have a drum kit and keyboards and all the things that we now have. We really had pots and pans that we bought at Value Village.
We started with a looping pedal, which allows us to record live on stage short passages of music, and then we can layer them.
Oh, you pretty thing, let's take off the wedding ring.
I had a wooden box that I stomped on, Luke had one kick drum, and then over the years it's just grown. We have about a million guitars up there, we have a full drum kit. So it's allowed us to build our songs up in ways that we couldn't have done just as two people with two instruments. So it's made the live show a lot of fun for us. Yeah. And kind of terrifying.
So are you just literally freaking out in your mind while you're programming all these instruments?
Melissa and I are guitar players, and yet we're playing keyboards and bass and drums and all these instruments that we don't really play. So I'll smash out a beat as best as a guitar player can, and we hope for the best. And of course, we're humans, so it's never perfect. Mm-hmm. Hopefully it's perfect enough that it sounds like music, but sometimes it's a train wreck, and we actually have to pull the plug. So there's a little moment where we kind of look at each other like, did we get it? Did we get it? And then we're like, I think we got it. And then we play the song. And if we didn't get it, we pull the plug and we start again.
Do you guys have like secret baseball signals that you give to each other about things on stage? Because it looks like so immersive.
Well, it's basically like, that sucked.
Yeah.
And that's how we know.
I'm living downtown. I'm
there's drone bombs a quiet street. You can dance with the devil, you can shuffle your feet. We can burn it down, we can rest when we're dead. We're a pillow fight on a concrete bed. Killing me. Streets are empty till you make them your home. But hey, do I know you? Have you ever seen me? Everything's gonna be alright.
That was Whitehorse at the CBC Music Festival. And now for something completely different and pretty magical. Inuit throat singing, courtesy of Tanya Tagaq. She's a Polaris Prize winner who hails from Cambridge Bay, Nunavut. Tanya's taken the Inuit throat singing tradition of the North and turned it into a musical force that's raw, primal, and powerful. You can't describe how unique Tanya is. You gotta hear her for yourself.
Traditional Inuit throat singing is done with two women, face to face, mouth to mouth. I never heard it growing up because it was actually banned by the priests, and people that went up there wouldn't allow throat singing, or, you know, it's the erasure of culture,
right?
But I didn't grow up really hearing throat singing. And then when I took it on, I could hear the land in the sounds. So I could like be home again. Like it's like I could carry a bit of that land with me, and it's very peaceful. Like during shows, there's so much peace in my head, like absolute calmness, even though it seems like there's a lot going on the outside.
Hi,
how do you drop into what you need to do for a performance?
Surrender. It's about surrender and really being a servant to sound. You know, you give yourself completely, and foregoing ego is very important. Like, we get so wrapped up in how we're supposed to be important, and we are, but really we're not. I think the shows get dictated and led by the audience without them realizing, because when you give someone your energy, like when you look at somebody, I think people have really lost their instincts, but we can feel each other out. And it's strange. Haven't you ever had that situation where you know someone's sketchy, or you know you're going to get along with a person? And it's because we learn how to read each other. And when there's a whole audience of people and I put something out and they all kind of collectively feel the same way, it's almost like it comes back and then they lead. Like, if they get scared, I'll be scarier. If they get angry, I'll be angrier. Like, it's just kind of becomes a circle.
I understand that it's different every time that you do it as well. Can you speak a bit to the sort of improvisational nature of what we're going to see?
I think that doing improvisation forces you into the moment. I'm always searching for things that force me into the moment, and like painting or performing or giving birth, like, you know, these kind of situations where you're completely absorbed with what's happening, and I find that very healing.
If there was one misconception about the North that you would want to clear up for the rest of Canada, what would it be?
Even though the statistics are so grim, it's balanced exactly by an incredible beauty and fortitude amongst people and trust, and it's, the land is so all-encompassing and truly healing. So I think that we would have been wiped out without this kind of love and connection we have with the earth. So it's gorgeous there too, is what I'd want to say.
More highlights of the best from the fest, go to cbcmusic.ca. Don't go anywhere. Lots more of this special coming up. I'm going to go somewhere, though. Don't you go anywhere.
Coming up, another killer tune by the New Pornographers. This plus.
You were a hip by century.
Hey Rosetta, pay tribute to the tragically hip.
You were a hip by century.
I don't really have like many musical heroes or anything, but like he's pretty close.
This is Graham Wright from Tokyo Police Club.
Hi, I am him.
He is he, and you're watching
the CBC Music Festival.
Yeah.
It's been an amazing day of Canadian music. You saw electric performances from Tokyo Police Club, Alvvays, Maestro, and Tanya Tagaq. Coming up, Hey Rosetta play a tragically hip cover you don't want to miss. But first, here are the new Pornographers with one more summer jam. Rosetta close out the CBC Music Fest with a heartfelt tribute to the tragically hip Gord Downie.
I don't really have like many musical heroes or anything, but like he's pretty close.
Well, they're all for Gord, but this one's for Gord.
I didn't really think much about this cover. I thought it would be a nice thing to do here in Toronto, where he's like so well loved. A tribute, just to say that we're thinking about him and we love him, you know.
First thing we climb a tree, and maybe then we talk, or sit silently and listen to our thought. Illusions of someday, cast in a golden light. No dress rehearsal, this is our night.
Sing along.
Missing a horn is sung. Tonight we smoke them out.
goodness. Thank you so much for coming along on this truly all-Canadian ride, coast to coast to coast. Thanks to all of the bands that rocked our festival, especially the ones that you saw in this special. The new Pornographers, Tokyo Police Club, Maestro Fresh West, Alvvays, Tanya, Tagaq, Whitehorse, and of course your headliners, who they're still making noise for. Hey, Rosetta. If you want to see more highlights from the festival, you can check us out at cbcmusic.ca. Music lovers, I'm Talia Schlanger. See you next time.